Hello everyone, in this video we will learn more about email segmentation, what it is, its advantages, and also how you can use it in GetResponse. So if you want to start learning about email segmentation, this is the video for you. Alright, so starting with the definition of email segmentation, we can see here that email segmentation is the practice of dividing your email subscribers into groups based on specific criteria. Well, in other words, this simply means that we will group people that have similar interests, for example, or that like similar stuff, right? So, and well, as we had mentioned, of course, when you segment your contacts, you will also have a lot of benefits or advantages here. And one of them is actually more engagement. And in other words, this simply means that you will see your open rates and click-throughs go up. And this is by the simple fact that you will send more targeted content, so meaning it will have more relevance to your contacts, and as a result they will simply click more and open more your emails. And this will lead to the next one over here, which is higher inbox placement rate. So if people actually engage with your content, if they are clicking, if they are opening, you will actually have a better reputation in terms of your domain that you use to send emails, which will lead to your email landing at the top of the inbox. Another thing to consider is that you will have a better understanding of your audience. So if you know the actual interests and likes of your audience, it will be better for you in a way that you will know them, so that you can send more targeted content, which will convert better. And well, if you expand your marketing activities as well, and if you are using paid ads, as you already know your audience a little bit better, you will be able to actually find the exact target that you want for your paid ads. So what are the interests? What do they look like? What are they? Where are they in the age group as well? So by knowing that, so through segmentation, you will be able to gather this information. And well, at the end of the day, everything will lead here to a lower cost, as you will acquire more targeted people in terms of campaigns. If you are actually gathering some contacts by your marketing campaigns, you will actually get more granular here and only have the people that match a specific criteria. And also you can segment in your account people that are engaging and not engaging, so that you can remove in a timely manner and based on how they behave with your content. And now let's see how this looks like. And now a very quick example here about email segmentation is about preferences. So this is the most obvious thing. So what do people prefer? Let's say that you have a shop and you sell coffee and tea. So this could be, perhaps if you teach languages, this could be two different languages, as you can imagine. And if you know which one people are tend to choose more often, so you will see where the money is as well and how to target these people. And just an example here on how we would do that. You would then send two different emails to these people, one about coffee and one about tea. Of course, you can imagine the same email and just replace the topic in the same email. So I chose two different emails here, so that you can look that we would simply target people in a different way. And now let's quickly look how we would do that in GetResponse. So let's imagine we have a website. So I use the website builder and one of the templates to get this one over here. And down at the bottom, I have a form. All right, so that's actually the first step that you should have. But of course, there are some steps before that so that you can add this field to your form. And this is what I'm going to show you right now. So what you need to do is to actually go to your account. You need to go to contacts and we need to create that field. So we need to go to custom fields. And just so that I can show you my example, I created one called favorite drink. And let me exemplify now. I will call it favorite drink here, then I would select here text, and it would be well, you would define what you want, but I want a single answer, so it will be this one over here or this one over here, and let's say coffee and tea, and then you simply save. Right, so once you have that, you can actually go to the website builder. And as you can see, I have a few websites over here, but you can simply click on your website. You can click to edit the website. And I'm just showing how you actually add these fields to the form. So I will find the form over here. And then you have fields. And you simply add custom field. And what did I call it? Favorite drink, right? All right. So that's how it would appear. And then when people click, they will see the options. But that's just so that you understand how you would add it to your website. And once you have it, then once people subscribe, you'll be able to check. And that's what I'm going to show you as well. So here I will go to contacts once again. And I will show you here on the search how we would do that. So we would go to advanced search. We would go to add condition. And here contact details, custom field. And we are looking for, in my case, it was favorite drink. So the previous one that I created for myself, not the example that I used to show you. And is, I'm pretty sure I chose coffee here. So I should appear here. All right, so you can see that I did that twice already. And you would simply save the segment as coffee lovers, for example. And whenever you actually send a newsletter now, you would use this as a segment for people who love coffee, and you don't really need to send anything about tea in this example. And of course, this is only an example to show you how obvious it is to segment someone based on their preference, right? And now, what if we want to get a bit more granular? So let's go back to the presentation. And if we go forward, so I already know this person likes coffee. But how does this person actually drink his coffee? So is it via with capsules, beans, or grounds? So how do they buy it so that I can then sell as well? And one way to actually discover that, and without asking too much information on a form, so no one wants to fill a really long form, right? That's why we only ask one question, and later on we can progress with something like this. So you can send a newsletter like this one here on the left, and place images here with some links to different places on your website where you sell capsules, beans, or ground. And once they click on a link, as you can see here, I set up an automation that I will show you in a second. Then we can assign a custom field automatically and send a thank you message. Or perhaps, as I mentioned in this newsletter here, we offer some discounts to people who actually let us know how do they have their coffee, right? So this is another piece of information that you can get from your customers. And now going back to GetResponse, we would now go to automation, and let me go over here and click on automation. All right, so I have an example already here, which is coffee info, and I would just click here. And as you can see, so this is what you could see in the presentation, which is when someone clicks a specific link in my newsletter, then they would be assigned a specific custom field as well. And then we can filter by that, and we can trigger another automation by that and develop a whole new flow with this as well. And so that I can show you that as well, let me go here, create a workflow, and I'll show you how that would look like. Just a quick example here. So in our case, since we will be adding a custom field, this means that a custom field would be updated. And this is the condition that we would start. Select a custom field here, and we would go with coffee, specific value, and equals capsule. So this is for people who would have chosen capsules. And then you can add a weights action here, link both, and let's say 5 days. That's just an example, of course, so just can know the power of segmentation here. And then you would follow up with messages, and this would be, for example, what are the most popular capsules that you sell, and how can you get the most out of the capsules, best machines for a certain type of capsules, anything that would actually help people develop the the interest in what you have to sell or to say about this specific type of coffee that they consume. And then you can simply follow up and keep nurturing. So we would call that a nurture flow based on a specific characteristic that they have. And then you can create a separate flow for each custom field that we assigned. So for ground coffee and for beans as well. And then you would simply publish. And this would work as when they click on the URL in the newsletter that we've sent, then they would enter here as the custom field would be assigned to them on the other workflow. So you would need two workflows for this, just for a matter of organization as well, over here. And well, so once you have that and you have your website here, you have already a way to actually get some information from your customers. And well, I simply gave you the most basic example so that you can see that it's very easy to actually find the preference of people when they sign up to your website, and then you can get more granular with time and ask things that you want to know slowly so that people don't feel overwhelmed as well. And then that's, as I mentioned, that's just one example, and the possibilities are really endless here, and you can actually target people based on their activity in your shop as well, so number of purchases. You can actually target by if they open your messages, newsletters, and you can choose one, apply, so who actually opened this message. There are many things that you can do and many types of ways that you can segment your customers, and I recommend that you actually look into our blog post here. And if you are not watching this video in the blog post already, make sure that you go through it. You'll find the link to it here on the top right corner or in the description. And well, go through it. We explain many of the examples here. You can use mine as an example. I use it for coffee and tea. You can use it for your language school or anything that you are teaching, perhaps. And well, I hope you found this video helpful, and I will see you in the next one.